Hello friends, I want to show you how to make a big bag holder for a wheelchair in this 3D printed pipe design here. But first I'll show you how to get the newest version of Freecad. Go to Google or your browser and type in Freecad web.org. Go there. Select download in the top here. This version in the front here is a very old version, so to get the newest one, go down to the release page here under. Select this, go down in the bottom. Here you can select a version that fits you for Linux, Mac or Windows. I normally use the biggest version for Windows. It's nearly 300 megabytes. Now download the zip tool, type 7 zip in Google and press enter and select the first one in the top here. Download the zip tool and you are ready to go. So I'm going to show you now how to make the pipe design here. This is for pulling a man against a bag on a wheelchair. I have drawn this. In another video I'll show how it works. You can make all the parts for making the mechanism. Yeah, so Freecad is very good. So let's close this. Make a new document. Go to part design. Make a new sketch in the XZ font plane. First we'll draw the plate that hold the bag holder. I'll make symmetry to this line here. Select the two outer markers and the center line, press S on the keyboard. There are a constraint that you have to delete now, so select this solver up here in the corner and press delete. Now set the distance from the outer of the box to the center here to 10 millimeters and draw two circles in here. Now sometimes the circle go away, just undo control Z. Now the circle is here. Draw another circle. Set the distance between the two circles to 200 millimeters and the length of the box to 220. Now select the two holes and make them 6 millimeters. Select the diameter tool up here, press yes, 6 millimeters, and we have made this nice sketch with 200 millimeters between the holes and the square 220. The height of the box I'll make 25 millimeters. Close the sketch, padded reverse direction, select reverse 10 millimeters, press OK. Now press V3 on your keyboard to get it wireframe. Now select all the corners, hold down the control key and select the fillet tool up here, make it 4 millimeters. Press OK, press V7 on the keyboard to get back. Now go to part workbench, make two boxes. The first box I'll make length 180 millimeters and wide 80 millimeters and height 180 millimeters. The next box I'll make 100 millimeters length, 50 millimeters wide and 50 millimeters high. Now transform the first box, right click transform, and move it down to where we want the, you set the movement, press control set to go back, right click transform, set the movement in steps to 10 millimeters instead. Now move the box down where we want the back holder. I'll move it out here and move it to the center. It's here. Move the small box the same way down here and out in the front. Let's see it from the side. It's from the side here. I'll move it up here. Let's see it from the front. Now we'll move it to the center. The big box is 180 millimeters and the small box is 100 millimeters. So it's, I have to see. The wide is 80. And no, the big box is 80 millimeters wide. No, the length is 180. I think I can move the small box. Let's try 40 millimeters in. It's 40 millimeters. I'm moving it in, so it is in the center here. Now we have the two boxes here. Now select the two boxes, hold down the control key, press control D on the keyboard or right click appearance and set the transparency to 80 so we can look through it. Now go to draft workbench and align it to the back here. So select the back of the box here and select the working plane control up here, and the grid will move to the back of the box here. Now select the polyline, it's this one here. Select the snapping tool to end of line here, it has to be turned on, and the lock here should be turned on. Now draw a line. Select the center of the line here and it will light up in the end. You should not select the point you want to start at. Just select the line and it will light up. You can see it lights up when I touch it. So now we are start drawing. Select the other end of the line here. I'm just selected the end. I'm just selecting the line and it lights up. Go down here in the bottom here. If you try to select up here, it's difficult to get it to attach. So select the line down here, and the same here, and up in the top here, and over here. So we get the back holder line. Afterwards, we will sweep a circle. Let's pass isometric view. And I have to think, go up here, and in here. Now we have the sweep line, press escape to stop. Now turn the two boxes off by pressing the space bar. Select the line, go down in the property window, set a radius for the line. I'll try to set it to a big number, 40. Now you can see it's not making a radius here, it is because the number is too big, so set it down to 15 millimeters. It's the fillet radius down here in the property window. Now it's nice and round. Now draw a circle to sweep around the line. To do that, we have set our working plane so it is aligned with the front here. So to do that, it's very easy. Just select a circle up here and select the snapping tool over here for end of line. Now draw a circle here. Just draw a circle. Select the circle here in the combo view and set the radius to 8 millimeters. Oh. Let's set it down to 4 millimeters. It's too big. No, it's the radius, so it's half the diameter. Let's set it to, it's 4 millimeters now. Now go to part design, eller part workbench. Select the sweep tool, put the circle in the selected property, set create solid and friend, sweep path, go to model, select the wire here, go back to the task, press done and press OK. And now it has sweep this nice back holder. You can give it a nice color if you want. Select the body, hold down the control key, select the sweep function, press control D or right click appearance and give it a nice color. We can make it, let's make it in it's a lot of stone materials we have over here. That was too boring. I'll just make it a color. Control D, let's set it to a color. So now we have a nice red back holder. I have made some other videos that shows how you can do this and how the draft workbench work. So play with it. The smart thing is when you have done this 3D sweep in the draft workbench, you can change it afterwards. Just go over here in the combo view, select the sweep and find the wire. The wire is here. Down in the property, you can find points. It's here. Select it. And you have a small box here. You can select the table. Yeah, and you can see where all the points are in X, Y, Z direction. If you can figure out which one you want to change, you can change them. We can try to change something. I'm thinking. Let's change this one to 0. Let's try that. 0, 0. -180, -180. Let's try to press OK. And now it looks like this. So you can change everything if you want. If you use this way of drawing pipes or wires, you can change it afterwards. So play with that. Have a nice day.